Hi, I'm Khalid Lomakuri and I'll be talking about two search algorithms. The first one will be the sequential search algorithm. Okay, now the sequential search algorithm goes through each index of a list and compares its target number to each index until it finds the target number. I've chosen 3 as our target number. Okay, so we first start by comparing 3 to the first index, which is 1. In this case, 1 is not equal to 3, and so we move to the next index. 3 is not equal to 5, so we move to the next index. 3 is not equal to 7, so we move to the next index. And then we see here, 3 is equal to 3, and therefore we have found our number. Now, sequential search is good as it works with unsorted lists, as you can see here, and sorted lists. However, it can be incredibly time inefficient, for example, when the target number is at the end of the list. To the binary search algorithm. As you can see here, we have our list, and we have our target number. The algorithm starts first by splitting the list in half. We check if our target number 2 is equal to the value on the right. 2 is unfortunately not equal to 5, so we then check if 2 is bigger than or smaller than 5. 2 is smaller than 5, so we move to the left, and this is about the right. Okay, we then split the list in half again. We check if 2, our target number, is equal to the value on the right. 2 is not equal to 3, so we check if 2 is greater than or smaller than 3. 2 is smaller than 3, and so we move to the left, and this is about the right. We then split the list in half again. We check if 2 is equal to the value on the right. 2 is indeed equal to 2, and therefore we have found our value. Now, unfortunately, the binary search algorithm only works with sorted lists, as you can see here. However, compared to the sequential search algorithm, it is much more time efficient.